Hey everyone, welcome back. It's Brian Gregg with another RWD screencast. Today we're going to be talking about something different. We have a brand new screencast series that I'm working on Vue.js. For those of you unfamiliar with Vue.js, it is a framework for reactive programming. Now, a lot of you have probably heard of it. Maybe you've used it. Maybe you know what it's for. Maybe you know specific use cases for what it's for. This screencast is going to be focused specifically on the building blocks of Vue.js and some of the very fundamental templating components. Just for those of you who are unfamiliar with Vue, it is a UI framework similar to some of the other UI frameworks that are on the market, such as React, Angular, Ember, and the like. I personally like Vue because of its very minimalistic feel. It's not as bulky as some of the other frameworks, like Angular in particular. It really is just composed of the Vue layer. There are some other components to Vue, which we may get into in some later screencasts, but it really does allow you to just pick out the pieces that you need and integrate the Vue layer of Vue.js into any of the other backend frameworks that you might be using, or any of the state-based frameworks that you might be using, etc. We're going to take a look at what Vue is capable of in this video. Vue uses templates that allow us the ability to declaratively render content on the page. This is done through creating an element on the page, where we will define our templates, and then we will subsequently, through JavaScript, declare an object using the global view object to reference that element on the page. And we're just going to take a look at what that actually looks like through some code here. So let's start by creating an HTML boilerplate here. There we go. We'll call this Vue.js, and we're going to add in our script tag here. And then off here on the Vue.js homepage, they've got a reference to a CDN hosted script, which we are going to include in our application here. And let's just take a look at what we have here on localhost. So we don't have much here, just a reference to Vue.js. So how are we going to actually start using this? Well, the first thing that we want to do is we want to create a div on the page here. And this div will give it an ID of, let's just call it my app. And this is where our entire template is going to sit. Now, down here in the actual script itself, I'm just going to add a script in here, which is going to be where we'll declare our object. We are going to declare a variable. We'll just call it app. And it is going to be based off of the view object prototype that we inherit from the library that we included right up top here. And then what we're going to do within this object is, first thing we want to do is we want to declare which element this is going to be in reference to. So the element that we selected up top here was called my app. And then we are going to add some data in there. And the way that we do that is we just create a data object. And we can have whatever we want in there. So we can put something in here like message equals, hey, I'm a Vue programmer. Okay. Now, that looks pretty good. And now what we've done in the bottom here in the script is we've actually declared an object. And that object is going to contain some data. Right now we've got some hard-coded values in there, but if we wanted to, we could be pulling those from a from an API, or you know, we can be serving those up from a backend application, and that can be you know, contextual data, whatever it is that we want. What we're doing though with Vue is we're setting up this relationship, this what we called earlier the reactive programming. It's really just a relationship between the DOM and JavaScript, which is going to constantly communicate between each other, so that anytime something changes in that object, it's going to communicate that to the template within the DOM. The template's going to update to reflect that new data, and we'll have this constant back and forth, keeping the objects in sync. That's what we call binding the data. So we're taking the data in JavaScript and we're binding it to the DOM. That's also what we mean when we call it reactive. So anything that changes in the view in the application is going to be updated in the view. So let's take a look at how that's actually going to work. We can say right here, the view syntax is to use the that double handlebars, and we could say message. Now, let's take a look at this here. Let's make sure that we add the dollar sign reference in there. And that's going to bind the data from our data object to our view. So how does it know that it's going to populate message within this div right here? Well, what we've done is by declaring the element in the view object as myApp, it knows to look for the myApp ID on our page, and then it is going to respectively bind any data within this data object to the template here. So if we wanted to add in another thing here called header, and say this is our header, and then we wanted to put up here some HTML syntax, say H1, slash H1, header. This is our header. Hey, I'm a Vue programmer. So we're taking all the data from here and again, binding it to the screen. There's some other things that we can do with Vue from a just a very simplistic standpoint. If we wanted to, we can control the data that we're presenting in our Vue using directives. Vue has a set of directives that you'd come to expect from a framework like this for, you know, conditions and for loops and things like that. So we're going to take a look at some of the built-in directives here. The first one we're going to take a look at, let's just create another member in our data object here called test, and we'll set that to true. And now let's say that we wanted to put in a conditional statement here to only display this message if the value of test was true. What we can do is we can actually create a directive in here. Let's put this in a span. And we're going to create a directive here called vif, and vif is equal to test. And again, because we have this test this test member in our data object, Vue is going to know that the vif directive has access to any of the members in that data object. So when we pass test in there as a value, it's going to know exactly what to bind that to. And there we still see it. And if we set this to false, it's going to hide it. So we now have the ability to bind our data. And think about some of the applications of this. If, say, for instance, you had a toggle switch next to a series of list elements. You can toggle them on or off. That would then set the state of that object in the application, and you could dynamically hide and show fields within our view. Just one last thing I want to take a look at. What we'll do is we're going to add in one more object here. Just call it ARR, and it's going to be an array of objects. Let's just add two objects in here, and they're going to have a value of, let's just call them testVal. Let's call them name. And Brian. And another one down here, name Sal. And now we are going to look at the, let's just create a unordered list. And we'll put in li. This is going to be a list item that is going to represent every element within our array. So we're going to say li, and we're going to say v4 equals item in ARR. And that is going to be data, I'm sorry, it is going to be item.name. And there we go. This is now looping through the entire array list here, and it's pulling every item, and it's presenting the name. So if we had a bunch more names in here, we could, let's just do this, let's just put Mary. And Jim, and again, I want you to think of the applications of this in a real program, going and pulling in data from an API or from some other backend source, and then giving you the ability to present that data in a view for the viewer to look at. So some really simple applications of the view framework here. Something to familiarize yourself with the basic syntax and how to set up a program. We're going to be taking a look at some of the additional features in our next screencast. So I encourage you to subscribe and to hit me up on the message board or on Twitter at IgnorantTuition with any questions, comments, or other things that you'd like me to cover. Thank you so much, and have a great evening.